from WDSU, News Channel 6 is on your side.
Okay? That's the only thing I have to say to you. I have nothing else to say, okay? You understand that?
What about those allegations?
Out on a legal loophole, the Attorney General wants a former deputy facing life in prison on rape charges back behind bars. And tonight, the I-team hears from a new alleged victim who was shocked to find out who she was dating.
What did you think when you found out you were dating a man who'd been indicted for aggravated rape and trying to force a defendant to have oral sex with him?
I was sick to my stomach because there were many nights that I laid in his bed with his gun a foot from my head.
A judge decides what to do with ex-Lieutenant Wayne Schaefer. Good evening, I'm Norman Robbins.
And I'm Camille Whitworth sitting in tonight for Chris. WDSU News Channel 6 reporter Richard Angelico is on your side now, live in St. John Parish with our big local story. Good evening, Richie.
Good evening, Camille. Well, today's hearing was actually continued, but not before the judge ordered Schaefer to wear an electronic monitoring device on his ankle at the urging of the state attorney general's office, which is prosecuting this case. And it was also the first time we saw Schaefer without handcuffs and got to ask him some questions, or at least try to.
Out of handcuffs and an orange suit, former deputy Wayne Schaefer came to court talking on his cell phone and refusing to answer any questions.
Talk to us for a minute. No, sir, I don't have anything to say to you, and I want you to quit harassing me. I'm going to tell you that right now, okay? That's the only thing I have to say to you. I have nothing else to say, okay? You understand that?
What about those allegations?
You understand that? I'm being harassed, okay? Quit harassing me, okay?
Also in court today, this woman from Mississippi, who unknowingly dated Schaefer while he was under investigation on rape and sexual abuse charges. She contacted the state attorney general's office after learning Schaefer's real name.
How did you find out the man you were dating was Wayne Schaefer?
I saw him the day before he was indicted, and he had told me that he was going to be indicted for a failure to read someone in Miranda warnings. And when I didn't hear from him that Monday, I just got online and basically Googled St. John Parish an indictment, and lo and behold, it brought up his picture, and that's how I found out.
Was that the name you knew him by?
No, I knew him by Brent Paul Pesch.
What was your reaction when you found out the guy that you were dating had been indicted for aggravated rape and trying to force a woman to have oral sex with him?
I was sick to my stomach because I had laid down beside him many times at night with his gun less than a foot from my head. So, I mean, thank goodness nothing ever happened to me. He was very verbally abusive. He did pull my hair once. Because he had claimed that I hadn't gotten my hair cut and that I was having relations with someone during the lunch hour.
The Attorney General's office plans on using the woman's testimony to show that Schaefer is capable of using false names and a potential danger to women. Today, the woman's name was added to a list of women Schaefer has been ordered to stay away from.
Now, since state law mandates alleged sex offenders released on bond be electronically monitored, the judge did order Schaefer to wear an electronic bracelet and not to leave St. John Parish without the permission of the court. The legal issues involving his release on bond were continued and will be heard by Judge Mary Hotard Becknell on March 5th. On your side in Edgard, Richard Angelico, WDSU, News Channel 6.
All right, Richard. And up to this point, Schaefer has been represented in court by a public defender. Today, the judge ordered him to fill out application papers to see if he actually qualifies for a court-appointed lawyer.